planter box garden this year did really, really, really well. I was super pleased with the harvest we got out of it. Hi, I'm Sarah, and welcome to Lohre Farm. I definitely think that next year we should do about double the amount of planter boxes and get started earlier. What I was super excited about was how well it did. The tomatoes grew really great. I wish I'd have kept up on the pruning a little bit better. Something for next year. The carrots I would have spaced out a lot more also,
as they kind of choked each other out. But we still got some really great carrots. The kids still love them. They're just, you know, baby carrot size. Still delicious though. Also, I would do definitely more planter boxes, and hopefully next year we can get the back greenhouse built up, which will give us even more space to put more planter boxes and also have another growing area, which would be amazing. Beets did fabulously. I'd probably plant more next year though. Same with potatoes. The potato harvest was really good, and we got to make a bunch of stews and mashed potatoes and all sorts of stuff, but I probably would do about triple than what we did this year, knowing how they did. And probably just stick with one variety, I think, instead of doing two. I don't know, although maybe if I make it bigger, then I do separate planter boxes of them. The garlic chives took off and are still doing really well. They're attracting a ton of bees. Honeybees and bumblebees. I don't think I've seen this many bees in my life in Minnesota this time of year. The beans did awesome. I think I'd probably plant a little bit less per planter box though, because they yielded a ridiculous amount but kind of got overgrown. But we didn't really have any problems with too many pests in there. The only area I had problems with pests was my back tomato garden, so I probably should have stayed up on that before they became a problem. You know, it wouldn't bother me so much if they just kept going back and eating the same tomato, but it's like they make one hole and then move on to the next. But I'm really looking forward to next year and really making this area a lot bigger and pruning back the tomatoes a lot more. I think we'll get a better yield if I do that. But it really worked out quite well. I didn't have to weed really at all back there between the straw being put down around the tomato plants and just the way everything grew in the planter boxes. There really wasn't much need for it. We did use a little bit of mulch, grass clippings specifically, and that seemed to work really great. Definitely will be saving grass clippings earlier on next year because they do work so great at covering everything that we did get. All in all, I think the planter box garden did pretty amazing this year. We didn't have too many failures back here, actually. The corn part in the front part of the back garden did amazing this year. We planted ambrosia corn, and it is the perfect sweet corn. You can't ask for a better one because it really grew up well and tasted well, and everyone that had it loved it and came back for more, and I was really, really pleased with it. I like that we only do the one variety, so we don't have any cross-pollination, and we don't do field corn either for that reason. So our sweet corn is honestly better than any sweet corn I've ever gotten anywhere else. Back garden did amazing. I'm really pleased with how well it turned out. A few things I would do differently though is I would plant watermelon. I don't know why I didn't think of doing that. We eat so much of it, I think that would be a really good thing to add next year. But the cantaloupe is surprisingly doing really well. They're really small still, but they're growing. But the cucumbers did amazing. We have had way more cucumbers than we can eat. We've had a lot of refrigerator pickles and cucumber salads and a whole bunch of other really great things. I'd probably do a little bit less of the lemon cucumbers. They're good, but I think I over we planted way too many of those. Plus, they're really a problem for cross-pollination. Because I had originally planted rows with just one variety in each row, but then when plants died for whatever reason, I did some transplanting, which I think is where I went wrong, because then cross-pollination kind of got a little bit out of control on me. Kind of forgot about that. So it's kind of nice to have these videos so I can look back on them too next year and be like, oh yeah, that's right, don't do that again. Don't forget about that again. Harvesting on the cucumbers will go for a while. It'll go till first frost. So we still have hopefully at least another month, month, probably till October of cucumbers going, unless we get an early frost, which it's Minnesota, so that does happen. But zucchinis did really well also. I think we'll stick with putting the plastic down and then taking them off, the plastic off.
It's a pretty good size one. They hide from me, I'm gonna be a leader.
You can definitely come back and harvest in the morning and then harvest again at night, the way everything grows. It gets all camouflaged back here. But we probably come out and harvest twice a day just to get some fresh stuff going. And like I said, it all kind of camouflaged. The other thing I would change would, I think we'll buy more of the green snow fencing to fence in this area a little bit more so the chickens don't have to be caged up as long as they have been, because I really prefer to have them wandering around and not have to give them feed. So that would also minimize cost of that.
Pumpkin patch is doing amazing. It's a pretty perfect one. They're not ready to pick. You can tell when they're ready to pick when the green stem turns tan or like a light brown, and then they just kind of pull right off the vine. So this one's looking good. It'll probably be ready to pick, I'd say probably October 1st, which is good.
So I think it would be well worth buying more fencing to get at least the back garden and my pumpkin areas protected from them so they can go out and play and run around, especially now that we're gonna have a ridiculous amount of them. In greenhouse number one, we planted the beets and green beans, and they did amazingly well. Especially since we had such a late start, because we didn't know what we were gonna do when the greenhouse was destroyed over the winter. So I was a little hesitant when we started growing back here, but the beans really took off and did an amazing job. We have harvested out of here 2-3 times a day with the amount of beans and beets.
These are looking really good. Good length.
I will definitely be doing beans and beets again, and I'll probably do more beets next year than beans, because you yield so much from the beans that you just don't need quite as many plants. But the beets, we eat through them like crazy, so I think I'll definitely be adding more of those, and probably earlier now that the greenhouses are set up. So we won't have such a late start. We'll be able to start early next year, hopefully beginning of May, which in Minnesota is considered early because you can get frost all the way to June. But it'd be nice to start greenhouse, maybe even April, if we can get the heat going in here. We can do a fall harvest of maybe some lettuces and beets and radishes, and then once we pull those, we can do beans and probably more beets again too, which would be really great, because the greenhouses really do give you a great head start on weather, especially if you're in a colder zone, and then you get a longer season, which is super important when you don't have that winter or that long spring or fall to get started. The greenhouses are really, really a good, not super expensive way to get more healthy food in your house without having to have everything canned.
Oh no, we're not going to have any beans left.
So I am super excited for that. I'm super excited to build our new greenhouse that we're going to have to add on to these so we can get our starter plants going much earlier. I think this winter we might even start some starter plants in our cellar. We'll see how that goes. Should be kind of fun, so keep an eye out for those videos coming this winter.
Couldn't figure out why it was so dark in here.
Oh my god, there's so much in here. So greenhouse number two, where I have my peppers, my yellow neck squash, which I have pruned back I think 4 or 5 times, but because of the climate in here they just keep coming back and overgrowing our beautiful walkway that my husband added into these greenhouses this year, which was a huge plus. It was a super nice surprise, and it had made it harvesting a ton easier having not dirt to walk on, but the actual the bricks. They worked out really well. Super excited about how well they did do. I didn't have to weed at all in here, not ever, not once. Between the plastic, the bricks, and what we planted, it worked out really, really, really awesome for that. The peppers are still doing great. I'm hoping they continue to grow all the way through first frost, maybe even a little bit after if we're lucky, because of the greenhouse climate. That would be awesome. We are in here harvesting once a day for the peppers, and we get a ton of them, so we've had a lot of those. We've had minimal amount of pests in here. I think we had a few peppers get eaten, but nothing too crazy, which was awesome. I do think next year less squash in here because it gets so overgrown, but they really exceeded my expectations on how well that they did in here. And the peppers also.
It's that time of year where I need a trailer instead of a basket.
The only thing that didn't work out as planned was the tomato box hanging planters. I don't think they got enough drainage, so that'll be something maybe we'll play with next year. Maybe we'll add some more drainage holes to it and see if that fixes the problem, or maybe we'll plant something completely else in here and put in shelving. Chaos garden. So this was an experiment from the beginning. I didn't think it was gonna be as amazing as it turned out. I got my sunflowers that I wanted planted, which are attracting a ton of bees. They're all over the sunflowers right now, even as I'm talking, just pollinating away. But they're looking beautiful and amazing. I didn't think that they would get this far because we planted this so late in the season. But we have gotten yellow neck squash, a couple baskets of beans already, and dill, so much dill, and cilantro, rosemary, even snap peas we found in here and are still finding a ton. I think we'll be able to harvest out of here probably for the next month for sure, the way things are growing. And kale, I've had a bunch of kale. The corn, I think we'll be able to harvest in maybe a month or so. That's growing really, really well. And then pumpkins, oh my God, the pumpkins. This so made me so happy that the pumpkins were doing so great, because again, we lost so much of our yard due to pond stuff that I was pretty sad about not having all the pumpkins. But I think that chaos has definitely made up for the pumpkins. They are just taking over and looking amazing. And if you would have told me back when we did this that it was gonna turn out like this, I would have said you were nuts. It's not gonna work, it's just gonna be a mess. Nothing's gonna have time to fruit anything. And I was wrong. It was an amazing experiment. I think it'll be something that we do again, because it was so fun to kind of just watch and see what came of it and how well it did and how well it's doing, especially for such a late start. But we've had some delicious meals out of here. Definitely a ton of beans. There's probably even more in here for me to pick right now. But yeah, it's super cool. If you've never done it, I say take your extra seeds, take a section of wherever you are, even if it's just a planter box, throw them together and see what happens. It's super fun.
We're gonna need a new table because my husband just broke it.